When you think about it after the din, what is there behind a one-point win?
Welcome to Bowling Between the Bays. This is our third show. And as we mentioned last week, unfortunately, due to the fact that there's no pennant because of the Vic Open, we won't have a show as such. It'll be half an hour of interviews, photos and comments that I was able to obtain while up at the Vic Open. Now, I know Michael last week went and said it was going to be all about me. And guess what? It is. However, just so that Michael didn't feel left out, I decided to ask people to describe Michael with just one word, and we have some very interesting responses to that. This is only a half hour show, but in the forthcoming shows, we actually have some really interesting guests that we will have. Todd Simmons, a well-known Vic rep and owner of Get Hooded, will be coming in as well. We also have Cooper Krause, that young bowler that we mentioned was going from Coringle back to Frankston. He's going to come in and actually have a mention about his point of view. Oops. And James Whitehead, our Bowls Australia representative for our region, has kindly agreed to come in as well. And we're also going to talk to someone from the Mornington Peninsula Shire Council who's been involved with the new lights at the different clubs. So we're going to find out what's involved with that. So without any further ado, let's have a look at some of the photos, interviews, and also some comments about Michael Stanley. And we'll see you next week on Bowling Between the Bays.
Matty Flapper up at the Victorian Open. Welcome to Between the Bays Bowl Show.
Okay.
Are we on?
Oh, sorry, we're on. Yeah, country drivers, what can I say? Well, here we are. We're on Bowling Between the Bays. This is after day one. We've been at, where have we been?
Well, we played at Namurka Golf.
Yep.
And then we just watched Mickey Vaughan play in the first knockout at Namurka Bowls Club.
Yeah, so both Danny and I didn't win our section. We won one, lost one.
Yep.
Would be the best way to describe it. I played Dane McKinnon. Actually got to 12 all, and then he decided to show why he plays for Victoria and also Altona. Because he outclassed me. And we went and saw Mickey Vaughan, who won his section, and he played against a fellow that...
Graham from Seymour.
Graham from Seymour, but he got through in his section, but there was only... someone didn't turn up. So, basically, he only had to play Michael Kalmeyer in that, so he got a pretty easy pathway through. I shouldn't say that.
Are you saying he had two buys?
Well, possibly. But what happened was he then knocked off Mickey Vaughan quite comfortable. Poor Mickey, he just couldn't get his grass, and that was a problem. Now, we're heading back now because we've been in touch with others at Shepparton Park that Tommy Lockies has not only won his section, but he's just beaten another section winner. So he will now go on and play yet again another round. So somebody else who's also won a section and beaten a section winner.
Hey mate, I'm in Liverpool and I'm wondering if you can help. Yeah, I need somebody. Not just anybody. Can you please? Please help me. Oh, that's great. Thanks so much, mate. I'll see you in a minute. Thank you.
Oh, what a good guy.
Hey, man.
Hey, James. Yeah, man.
Oh, thank you so much for this.
Good, yeah, no, happy to help.
I don't know Liverpool that well, see.
I'll show you around.
Thank you so much.
You know, I can't come up here without showing people around, so it's perfect.
Do you mind if we listen to some music?
Oh, I'd love to.
Should we see what's on the radio?
See what's on the radio.
Ask the girl what she wanted to be. She said, baby, can't you see? I want to be famous, a star on the screen. But you can do something in between.
Let's go!
Maybe you can drive my car.
Yes, I'm gonna be a star.
Whoa!
Baby, you can drive my car. And baby, I love you. Beep, 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 yeah. Beep, 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 yeah.
All right, hell of a song.
So, we're heading back now to see that. We've also been told that Ash from Frankston has got through, won their section. We haven't heard how he's gone with his against another section winner. And we've also been told, who was that again?
Dave Bewley.
He got through, but he got even a bye. It must have been the way the numbers ran. But he didn't even have to play another section winner. So he's going straight through to play another double section winner. And didn't you tell me that from some of...
Tex.
Tex. Big Tex.
Tex McClellan.
Tex. He got through as well. So we'll sort of keep updated and see how we go. But we're a little bit disappointed because we decided to do this a little bit earlier in the day, didn't we? On the way there.
We did.
And we thought we did a pretty... Well, I think we did a bloody good job, and for some reason it hasn't been received at the station. So we're hoping this will work, mainly because I'm using my video, and hopefully it does. But what did we talk about? I mean, we're chewing the fat over a lot of things on the way. Time passed.
It did.
The time passed a lot. What are we talking about? We spoke a little bit.
Being a warm day, we spoke about hydration and by the amount of trips to the toilet you took, I think you took my advice and you had plenty of water today.
Yeah, no, once you start going, you know, you never stop. What do they say? Once the seal is broken.
The seal is definitely broken.
It goes. No. Now, the other big thing that was up here were these damn flies. They were everywhere, weren't they?
They're friendly little things.
Oh, no, absolutely everywhere. No, but what we were talking about was hydration, how you definitely need to do it. And we're speaking about how Johnny Curtin mentioned you've got to do it actually not on the day, but 2 days before. And not only that, you probably shouldn't hit the grog the night before, which quite a few bowlers do, to say the least.
Yeah.
So I was thinking that maybe Mikey Cowmeyer probably would have had a bit of a dry mouth, I would have thought. Maybe.
Even a few reds, was it?
Oh, he doesn't like reds, but he was certainly having a little go at the rest. So there was that. And we're talking about warming up. And what I'm trying to do is see if I can get a physio on the show so we can actually discuss things that you should be doing before a match and maybe talking about looking after your body, what you can do during the week, maybe look at doing something like Pilates like I do, doing the core. Have a good core, have a good pelvic floor. So I'll be looking at trying to get a physio in as well. And I think I've pretty well organised it, which is great.
What's one word to describe Michael Stano?
I've got the boys from West Rosebud. I've got a question for you guys. What would be one word to describe Michael Stanley?
What do you reckon?
Insipid.
Wait a minute. One word to describe Michael Stanley.
Insipid.
One word to describe Michael Stanley.
Insipid.
One word to describe Michael Stanley.
Ooh, let me think about that. Insipid.
Going? Okay. We're up at the Vic Open and this man just gave us an absolute hiding with his team. But tell me, you know Michael Stanley, right?
Know Michael well.
If you had to name Michael with one word, what would it be?
There's only one word you can answer that, and it's insipid.
Then we were having a chinwag about what was happening at Balnarring. And unfortunately, there was some sad news there recently.
Yes. Unfortunately, our chairman passed away after a short battle with cancer.
Yeah.
Grant Powell, he will be sorely missed at the club.
Yeah.
So, it's been a very sad week down there.
So, you've sort of taken that position, but, you know, some pretty big shoes.
Yeah.
to feel, really.
Yeah, so I was deputy chair while he was having, you know, like doing his chemo and that.
Yep.
So, yeah, so I'll take over the role.
Yep.
So, obviously wish I didn't have to, but unfortunately, got to move on.
Well, you do. And talking about that, I mean, you've got your artificial green, and you've also got your grass green down there as well. And tell me, what do you prefer to play on? Where do you put your number one team on? Because it often different people play. Because I mean, is it more an advantage to play on the grass, or is it an advantage now to play on your synthetic?
Yeah.
Which way do you play it?
Well, there's mixed feelings about this down at the club. Obviously, you know, like different opinions. We have been playing on the needle punch on the carpet.
Yeah.
For the top side. So me personally, I like the grass better.
Yeah.
But you know, so that's where the majority of the skips want to play. So that's where we play.
Yeah.
And that's pretty much it. So.
Yep. I mentioned this in one of the other shows, was at what point can they change playing pennant on grass or on synthetic? So for argument's sake, that you had it allocated that you were going to use your grass green, then it pours. All right. Are you able then to switch it to the synthetic? That's a question I asked.
That's an interesting one. I've never come across that. So, I suppose the way I look at it, and I could be wrong, that as long as not, you know, like it's still before the scheduled practice.
Yep.
For the opposition, you know, so like as long as it's before then, I can't see why you can't change it. You know, if the opposition come and practice during the allotted time, then I'd say it'd be too late. You can't say, right, you know, we're playing on this green now, you know, even though you're practicing. Yeah, so that's just the way I look at it. But honestly, not sure of the ruling on that.
Okay, and being the devil's advocate, what about the other way around, okay?
Yep.
They're playing a top team. Mm-hmm. Top team.
Yeah.
It's down with rain.
Yeah, haha, I see it, yes.
Okay. What would stop you from swapping from the synthetic to the grass and saying, hang on, unplayable, therefore it's a draw, share the points, 9 points each? What would stop that?
I would really hope that wouldn't happen. I'd be gobsmacked if any club did that, you know.
But can it be done?
Well,
big question.
It stopped raining. You've got a waterlogged grass green, and you've got a decent artificial. Well, it's not going to be a good look if you say, "Oh, we've got to call it off because our grass green's no good."
Yeah,
you know. So, that would be a pretty poor act.
The Rye Hotel's been around for 80 years and is renowned for their good old-fashioned service and hospitality. Function facilities available. Phone 5985-2277, The Rye Hotel at 2415 Point Nepean Road, Rye.
The story began on a quiet coastal road in this backyard. It was the summer of 2006. At Jetty Road, we're very serious about not taking ourselves too seriously. Come say hello. There's a beer waiting for you.
Battery World now open in Mornington.
We know batteries. We know our 75 D23Ls from our DIN 65 LHs.
All right, well, let's get off the negative, because we were talking about, when we did it before, about how we need to be more positive about
more
things.
More positive,
Definitely about that. And a big positive is the camaraderie that we definitely have up here at the Vic Open with all the other players from all the other clubs, how basically we don't become separate clubs, we become like one team for the Mornington Peninsula.
Absolutely, it's one of the best parts about coming away up here, you know, catching up with all you guys from, you know, different clubs. You know, we're only usually catch up during pennant, so.
Yeah.
And then, we're supporting each other. We really want everyone to do well. You know, like, so back there watching Mickey. We're now off to Shep Park to watch Tom.
Yep.
So look, we've both, in, you know, a few times progressed through the knockouts and have always greatly appreciated the support.
Yep.
That's one of the best parts about coming up here.
That's what I like about it. And I think in the future we were talking about if there was a way that we could actually get up and try and live stream some of the matches that Mornington Peninsula bowlers are playing and actually stream them back to the Mornington Peninsula. We certainly have the platform to be able to do it, and I believe we have the audience based on the numbers that are watching live streaming of pennant matches on Saturday as well. So it would be very interesting as well. I like it.
Yes. How has that been going, live streaming?
Really, really well. Yeah. I think he throws them across about 9 platforms.
Okay.
And there's a couple of other people who do other ones with cricket and football and a few other things. I think the bowling has outranked the cricket and the football, which is mind-blowing.
Yeah.
As far as the number of people who are watching it as well.
Okay.
So we're only hoping we get bigger and better things as far as all this live streaming is. And that was something a year ago, almost to the day, that we were talking about the bowling show and how it could be improved. And that was when it was just on, you know, the air. It wasn't visual.
Yeah.
So I'm sorry, yes, you poor people are looking at our ugly tushes.
Yeah.
But
apologies.
The reality is, you said, that's the way to go, because there is one that was happening in Bendigo, wasn't it?
Yeah, so that's why I brought your attention. Have a look at the Bendigo League's podcast. They do a great job.
Yep.
And onwards and upwards is the way to go, I reckon. Plus, it has the added advantage of being able to watch it whenever you want to.
Correct.
You know, so like for myself, like being a night shifter and... I used to get home, try and get a couple of hours kid before pennant.
Yeah.
But so I couldn't really stay up at 8 o'clock, 8:30 to listen. So no.
Yeah.
It's a very positive move.
Yeah.
I only get better.
Yeah. And the thing about it, everyone, is that up here, you go out for dinner and you actually bump into people. Last night there was a table from Mount Eliza. You popped on in and visited.
Yeah.
That was sort of preordained that you do that, which was lovely. I know that you were there to watch the match, which apparently was only a draw, the boxing fight.
Yeah,
it was only a draw last night, apparently.
Yeah.
So our company was far better than that by the sounds of it. And then behind us was not a lot from Dramana and also West Rosebud. So we just keep bumping into that. But not only that, even people that you play against previously, and this is where you...
Yeah.
Catch up. I think Graham Everett also, I think he's playing for Mentone. We see him, his wife Trudy's a member at our club. It's just a lovely social way of catching up with everybody. So it's good.
It is. No, the moving the bowl, the Vic Open to Shepparton and surrounding clubs has been a winner, absolute winner.
So. But we had to get up early. That's the thing. Now, we weren't too bad. We're north. We're heading back into Shepparton now. But how long did it take us? It took us a good half hour, didn't it?
Half hour, yeah.
Half hour north.
Yeah.
But tomorrow or the next day, I know I'm playing Benalla, so I've got to go. That's, what, 90 minutes or something?
Short of an hour.
Let me over exaggerate. Come on,
I'm sorry.
Leniency. All right, about an hour.
Yeah.
But we've still got to drive.
Oh, yeah.
So that's a fair way. That's for sure. But it's superbly run, you've got to say that anyway.
Yeah.
So it's good. All right, is there anything else we need to talk about, big fella? Oh, yeah, well, what about your weight? You mightn't recognise this man. How many kilos, my friend?
I've lost 25 kilo in 14 weeks.
Cool.
So, now, 15 to go.
15 to go?
Yeah.
And I thought I was kicking goals at 15 myself. Now, a bit of history about yourself. Where did you start bowling?
Well, I started at Balnarring.
So you did start at Balnarring.
Yeah.
But I got to know you at Hastings.
Yep.
So how did that come about?
Oh, look, just after a change. And, so after about 6 or so years of Balnarring, went to Hastings and lucked it for a few premierships, so to speak.
Oh!
And then eventually, you know, sort of went back, yeah, sort of back to where it all started to help out Balnarring.
Yep.
So, yeah.
That was good.
Yeah.
Now, so we were also talking about where you thought Balnarring might end up in Division 2 South and what you thought your prospects were going to be for this season.
Yeah, so basically, we'll struggle a little bit, you know, aim obviously to make the top four. Yeah. We've got workers that are in and out, a couple of people going on holiday, so just when you can't get a settled team, it does make it difficult, but that's just the way it is. You move on, you keep trying to win. You know, we were very lucky getting the points first round after getting the flogging, so we'll take that. Win by default. I'm sorry, Rosebud Country Club, that was pretty rough.
What did they do? Did they have an unregistered player or something?
I think so. I haven't asked, so I'm tipping it was an unregistered player.
Yeah, that's always unfortunate, but in last year they let it ride.
Yeah.
Okay, and previous towards that, I know with Mount Eliza, it was the difference that when they decided to split the Division 1 from 2, that those 18 points, which happened with us, effectively put us in Division 2. Last year there was a little bit more leniency, but I know they've toughened up on it yet again, and they've said no. You know, from go to woe, if you do, you know, unregistered players or any other, anything else like that, well, then you're just going to unfortunately lose the points, and that's what's happened, I've noticed.
Yep. And that's fair enough. Rules are rules.
Yep.
You know, once you start bending them and breaking them, you know, then you're going to do it for everyone. It makes it even tougher for those that are putting their hand up to run the show. So, I totally agree with what they've done.
Well, Danny, can I say what a delight it has been to catch up with you again, genuinely. We've always seemed to almost play at the same venues.
Yes.
And we usually do a bit better than we did today, my friend.
Yeah, we're saving ourselves for the pairs. That's what
it is.
See, last few years we've been too exhausted, so that's our excuse.
Tomorrow's the day.
Yeah, we're going to stick with that excuse.
So tomorrow is the pairs, which is Sunday, and then Monday we've got the triples, and then from then on that's anyone sort of the pointy end of the finals.
Yeah,
is what's happening from that point. So, but we actually met last night. Danny said we realised we were at the same place, so what do? Like many people do, different clubs, going to the same venue.
And carpool, environment.
We're carpooling, and I can tell you the trip has gone a lot faster. Having a good chin wag with you, my friend.
Always good catching up with you.
So Luke, thank you very much. And so you need to say something in there. Remember what we practiced it. So you need to look in that camera. You need to say, I am, and your name, and you're on Bowling Between the Bays.
Yes,
okay, all right.
I think I've got it.
Okay, let's go.
So, my name's Danny, and I'm Bowling Between the Bays.
I like it. Okay, that's all from now.
Okay, we're with Wayne Spencer at the City of Frankston Bowling Club. Wayne, tell us about your bowls career.
Commenced bowls at Frankston RSL. Played for about 6 or 7 years and gave bowls away for 12 years and have only recently started up again at City of Frankston.
When you played in the very strong RSL teams?
Yeah, I was lucky to be there when RSL were probably the powerhouse of the peninsula in bowls. But unfortunately, the demise of RSL saw everyone go in different directions, and I'd stopped playing just shortly prior to that happening. Just decided to give it away for a while.
You've been back here a couple of years, and did you play in the big successful sides last year?
Yes, I did. Yeah, played in the top side since I've been back here for 3 years, and lucky enough to play in last year's premiership side, which was really good for the club, be very exciting, and we had a great year.
Did you play in the subsequent games?
Yes, went to Moama. It was the first time I'd been to Moama, and that was a great experience. To win our zone and then go to Moama and represent everyone was really exciting and just great competition.
You're very well known in football circles down here. Tell us a little bit about your career.
You came from the western suburbs and came across here and started off at Red Hill and had a coaching stint at Red Hill. Went and helped at Coringle, coached there for a few years, went to Pines and then came back to Coringle. Fortunate enough then to coach the Mornington Peninsula Interleague side for a number of years.
And what about players that came through that side?
Look, we had some great players that have represented the peninsula, probably big names like Simon Goosey and Tim Allen and Paul Williams. There was been some really talented people, and from there I went to Danny Nong Stingrays and got involved in the under-18 TAC Cup side, and again fortunate enough to see some great young talent come through there.
In your work career, what did you do?
Insurance loss adjuster, so working for insurance companies doing claims, and currently work for a company called Steamatic, which is the Australia's largest restoration company. So still working, unfortunately.
Thanks very much, Wayne. That was very insightful.
Thank you.
Beautiful.